Yes. Okay. Well, we have a little more corporate news, especially on the earnings that came yesterday. JSW Energy's fourth quarter earnings were broadly in line with the analyst estimates. Bottom line was supported by a deferred tax element. Kevin Lee spoke to the managing director and CEO Prashant Jain, and Jain says he is betting on a better FY20. Listen.
We are very positive and optimistic about FY20. In terms of, you know, contracted capacity, we will be doing close to 90% in FY20. We have already tied up short-term contracts for our Ratnagiri as well as Vijayanagar plant. And also we are seeing a strong pipeline, and this tie-up can further go up. So it will be much better than FY19.
You mentioned in the presentation that now that you're not looking at the EV space anymore, you're more interested in both organic and inorganic opportunities in power. Your Salboni plant will be commissioned in the first quarter of FY21. You're also talking about rejuvenating the hydro plant. How much of this do you think will happen in FY20?
So two plants will get commissioned in FY20. One is Nandyal and another is Salboni. These two plants will get commissioned. We are also planning to revive Kutiyar project. I am very quite optimistic that we will reviving this project in FY20. And in terms of higher PLF, also for doing the short-term contracts as well as the medium-term contracts for Vijayanagar and Ratnagiri, I am very optimistic. And I am seeing that the JSW Steel is also increasing its capacity at Ratnagiri and Dolvi as well at Vijayanagar. So the visibility is coming up very much for full tie-up of the entire capacity.
In terms of inorganic opportunities, what are the sectors you are looking at?
We are looking at both thermal as well as renewable, and in thermal we are seeing a lot of stressed plants within NCLT and outside NCLT. We are seeing quite a lot of opportunity, and I am quite hopeful that FY20 will be much better in terms of the consolidation in power sector than in FY19.
Let's talk a little bit about the EV space, because for over 2 years now, we've been excited at all these press conferences. We've been talking about the JSW car. You decided earlier in last year to scrap those plans. You mentioned that it is a challenging environment and there have also been policy shifts. Can you elaborate on that a little bit?
So, as you see in FAME II policy, the shift is towards the mass transportation system. More and more incentives have been announced for the electric buses, three-wheeler, and also for the taxi segment for individual cars.
You had outlined a spend of about 6,500 crores on the EV project. You mentioned that you've spent about 32 crores on the project, out of which 22 crores was this year. What are the plans with the rest of that money now?
So this was a capital expenditure which was planned, which was coming out from the internal accruals, because as we are generating cash up to, you know, cash profit is in to the tune of 1800 crores to 2000 crores. And now we are going to utilize all this money for the consolidation in power sector, and we would like to grow organically and inorganically. Our debt to equity has come down to 0.85:1, so we are highly under leveraged company, and we have enough headroom to grow and also to plow our future cash flows into the power sector.
One last question on the JSPL deal about the Tamnar asset. The long stop date is approaching in June. What's the visibility on that, because it's been fairly back and forth? Are you confident that you're going to secure that asset, or have you given up in some sense?
Visibility is less to secure that asset, but long stop date is June 30th, and either the we will get the money or we will get the asset.
All right, that's JSW Energy. Now we need to take a quick break. On the other side, plenty of trading ideas coming up with the technical experts, Sudarshan Sukhani, Mitesh Thakkar and Prakash Kaba.